What's up, YouTube? This is James, and I'm back with another Rush reaction. Today, we're paying homage to the legend, Neil Peart. Hopefully I said his name right this time, as it is his birthday. So I wanted to say happy birthday and do a Rush reaction. This was suggested to me. It's Cygnus X-1, I guess it's book one. I'm about to get my ears ready and get my brain ready, probably. I don't know how much breaking down or trying to figure out what they're talking about I'm gonna have to do. But judging by the name and knowing that it's Rush and how long the song is, probably a lot. So go ahead, like, comment, subscribe, and let's just get into it so we don't waste any time here. Rush, Cygnus X1. Book one. Very space sounding. So it's a black hole. That was a little loud. So I guess that was the final blast of glory. The star blew up and became the black hole. That's what my guess is, what that sound was right there. Last time I'm gonna pause it. Is the screen black on purpose? Like, did they do that because it's a black hole and signifying space or whatnot? That said, I'm already completely sucked into the song. Just sonically, it's pulling me in. But just curious about the blackness. Mm-hmm. One of the reasons I love Rush is all of the change-ups. Like, if you've seen any of my other videos, you know I love change-ups. They have them all the time, and I just love it. Real quick, before we get into the lyrics, just to pause to appease YouTube, and they don't need music videos for their music. Like, the music itself tells the story. Like, right now, without even any lyrics, like, I have a story going on in my head after what, you know, the beginning was about space, and like, I don't know, I just pictured them on the spaceship or something, building up to some sort of climax. But I don't even need a video or lyrics to get me there, but now the lyrics are here, so it's gonna be another ride.
Invisible to telescopic eye, infinity, the star that would not die.
He said on his ship, the Rasenate. Rasenate. Why does that sound familiar to me? I feel like it's the Rasenate. Shit, there's a TV show that has a spaceship on it named that, that's more recent, but it's also from a book that I read way back in the day. I can't remember exactly. Rasenate. Something Spanish. I can't remember. It's like high school. But let me know in the comments. Rasenate. Fuck. Is it a horse? Rasenate? I don't know. But anyways, it sounds like we're... in the ship and moving towards the black hole is what I'm gathering. Wait, on my ship, the- something about the siren song and the ship cannot resist for long. So this ship is being called towards the black hole. Y'all know what a siren song is. Very nice. So damn dramatic. So they're getting closer. It sounds like he said spinning out of control, maybe. I'm gonna have to run it back a little bit. Thanks, yeah. To run that back a little bit. I wasn't sure exactly what he said. Okay. Basically asking, will he be torn apart? It's a heartbeat. Wow. All right, so it was Rush, Cygnus X-1, book one. Basically about a black hole. They take the spaceship, to the black hole, towards it. It talks about how the siren song pulls them near, as they get closer, you know, they're out of control. And basically asking the question, what happens if we go through it, I think, is it, did we get ripped apart? Is there more? And based on what I heard at the end, there's a heartbeat, so it sounds like they went through it. And we're left to wait. It sounds like there's more on the other side. And you don't get ripped apart. Knowing Rush, there's probably like 15 double meanings to the song on deeper levels. On the surface, it's just a good old fashioned, I won't say a good old fashioned rock song, but it is a good old fashioned rock song. But it's a Rush story about an actual black hole and going to it, and then it sounds like going through it. So, a song written by written by Rush. A story, you know, that can only be told by them, based on real life things and, you know, their imagination, which is cool. If there are double meanings to it, hidden stuff, you know, other stuff that mean things, let me know in the comments, because I didn't really catch them. It was a little hard for me to understand some of the stuff he was saying, as you can probably tell, on the first listen. But I usually don't like to have the lyrics up, just because I like to hear it and not know what they're saying and try to figure it out. But musically, it was awesome. I love change ups, and probably had 15 different change ups. I feel like it was literally telling the story of how I kind of, you know, started off slow, picked up, got kind of hectic, calmed down, even more hectic, and then at the end, very calm. Which is dope. Obviously, drums are on point as usual, vocals on point, everything. So I'm looking forward to book two, which I guess is probably going to tell the story of what happens after they've gone through the black hole, just a guess. But I guess that would be coming up next. I'm not sure if I'm going to get to that as part of Neil's birthday, or if it will be later, but either way, go ahead and subscribe and you'll get the notification for when I do it. Like the video, comment, all that fun stuff, and again, RIP Neil, and happy birthday, and hopefully you guys enjoy the video, and be sure and have a good day, and until next time, guys, deuces.